good game and a lot of fun. And now it's on PlayStation 4, and it's been a couple years since I've played it, but oh cool, look at that. Yeah, I highly recommend it for anybody that's into Diablo type games. I think you'll like this. Game looks good. It plays very well. It might take a minute to get to understand the controls. I think it's just weird for me because I played it on PC and it's so much different on the controller. But yeah, it's a really good game. I think you guys will like it. Let me know in the comments if you've tried it, if you like it, if you've played it, and what you think of it. Well, this character's just starting out. It's, I think I'm only like level 6 or something right now. But this is in PlayStation Store now, and it's on sale. So for all you that like these type of games, these top-down RPG type games, I would definitely suggest it for people that like Diablo type games. Oh, my health, wow. This character I've not played before. This is a new character. I think it was DLC. But all that comes with the game in this version. I would probably recommend for first-time players the Hunter class. There are three classes. There's a Magic class, there's a Hunter class, which is like melee, two swords, and or you can use guns ranged. And then there is this class, kind of a steampunk sort of science gadget contraption type class. I've never played it before, but starting to click with it a little bit, I think. I don't know. But I would probably suggest the Hunter class for beginners. You can do dual swords. You grab one sword and a pistol, I think. Or rifles. You do have a companion with you. She's a ghost, and she can do ranged and or melee. This is a skill tree, and it's pretty big, actually. Let me see. I've got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 16, 18, 20. I think there's 20 to 24. Maybe 30, actually, different skills you can use. And then there's also these auras and tricks that you can use as well. Quite a bit of skills, actually. And your companion also has skills in this game that you level up. You have body, dexterity, willpower, and luck, like in a lot of games. These are items, very much like Diablo. Your armor. There is a crafting system in this game. Upgrading. Alright, destroy the signs. Oh, is that these things? Go get this one over here. It's this little robot. I think I can have a couple of them out at a time, yeah. No, if I can keep pulling them out or if I can only have two. Let's see. I think you can only have two right now. Maybe if I upgrade that, I can have more. I'm not sure. Like I say, I just started this this character. Just wanted to put a video up real quick. In case people are interested, they can check the game out for themselves. And I'll put some gameplay up as well. I did play it on PC and beat the game. I loved it. It was great. And I played it in beta. But it's been fairly refined now, and it's come to PlayStation, so thought I'd go ahead and get it again. It also, like I say, it comes with all the DLC that you used to would have had to pay for extra. With the different classes and extra content. It's also co-op, so and multiplayer. And it says there's PvP. I haven't tried it. Don't even know how that works. But I'll definitely check it out and do a video on it. I just downloaded it and started it. Like I say, this class I hadn't played with prior. It's kind of a ranged class. He's got little gadgets and mines and a flamethrower. And this, basically it's a mortar launcher, grenade launcher type weapon. And I'm sure there's quite a few other skills, I just haven't unlocked them yet. But this is the Incredible Adventures of Van Helsing. Yeah, that's helping a lot. She's starting to ice them up now for me. Damage these little robot spiders are actually doing. Should probably check that out. Because mines as well. I haven't really run out of mana yet. Pretty good. Got him.
Stop it, Hunter. You are fighting the wrong enemy.
Really? You almost ripped out my heart.
I was defending my pack. Instincts. You know how it goes.
And your prisoner.
You know how it
we
goes.
We tried to save him. He was injured, so we took him in.
He was injured.
Saved him? From who?
The machine men from the city. They hunt us down to experiment on us. Take this man and go.
Alright. You might be right, but you're still a rabid beast. I have to get rid of you. I don't know. What do you think? Should we kill him or let him go? I'm going to let him go because I know I killed him before. So.
I appreciate that. I'll leave you in peace.
Maybe there'll be a quest later.
My word. That was an incredible rescue, Hunter.
And an entirely pointless one, so it seems.
Don't say that. Good deeds are never pointless.
Which means that you'll answer my questions, right?
Certainly. But I must return to the village immediately. See you there.
See you there. Yeah, cool. We got some unidentified boots, some green boots. Like I say, this game is very much like Diablo. And it's also its own game, and it's in the Van Helsing universe, you know, so there's werewolves and vampires, and then it's got this like whole science steampunk type way about it. Right now I have this flamethrower ability, the mortar. I also have a mortar that'll shoot shrapnel everywhere once it explodes. Try to get a shot of that. There's that. I got this shield here, and this little robotic spider. I can put two of those out at a time right now. This little guy right here follows me around, as well as these little three mines I can put down.
I can't do that.
And yeah, this is the arcane mechanic. I got, like I say, there's a lot more skills here to unlock that I've not even seen. But you can only really have, let's see, about six out at a time. And there's also a lot of passive abilities that you can unlock with this game. And then your companion, Katrina, the ghost girl, she also has a lot of different skills. You can do her melee or ranged. And right now she's kind of just clear or transparent. I haven't given her any potions. I'm pretty stingy with my potions. You can give her potions, but better off probably using them for yourself. She does do some work. She does. You can also use her for attack, defend. She'll also pick up items for you. But anyway, this game is it's a lot of fun. If you're into the top-down type style games and you like Diablo type games, like I say, I would recommend. I've just started on this mechanic class. I would probably recommend doing the hunter class, and that one will have a sword or two swords or a sword and a hand cannon. That one's a lot of fun and effective. Fairly simple controls, like I say. I just a little weird because I played this first on PC, so. Oh god, those guys do a lot of damage. These ranged guys are crazy. These guys right here, they do a lot of damage. There we go. And there's just a whole story. There's a whole story mode. I mean, this game has it's a decent story. The levels are good. This is the first level, and I'm just trying to complete a few little quests and then go turn those back into town. Let's see. I don't even think I haven't even opened up all of this. We'll just go over here to the portal. But anyway, I just wanted to put out a quick video and show some of the fresh gameplay of Van Helsing, The Incredible Adventures of Van Helsing. And I want to know if you guys are playing it, if you've played it, if you're going to give it a try. I like it. I do recommend it. Like I say, if you like Diablo, you probably would like this game. It's less than $20. I think it's $14 right now, and very worth it. When I got this game the first time, I think I paid like $39.99 on PC. So it's a real good sale right now. I think it's like $20, but it is on sale.
The monsters have been
right
trying
now.
To sneak into the village.
So I went ahead and picked
you
it up.
Know, this brings back some.
Oh,
great.
It's the hunter again. I'm
but anyway,
glad to
thanks
see
for coming
you.
And checking out the video, guys.
Again,
I appreciate it. I appreciate all the support.
Morgover,
and I'll talk to you guys later. Take it easy.
To the other side of the mountain.
I sense another butt coming up.
But you have to use the ancient ink gate in the swamps. It opens into the tunnels.
Yeah, I remember
it's
the swamps.
It's easy to find your way around here.
All right.